Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Mother 3, and last time we beat the pork tank and watched a Drago come and save the day, and finished up Chapter 3, and now it's time to begin Chapter 4, and Chapter 4 is really when the game begins to change for the better, because we get a money system, and we begin to get all of our party members together, and it's personally when the game gets better in my opinion. So, let's go ahead and begin. Hello, my frog. Shall I record everything that has happened so far? Yeah, might as well. Doo-boo. Hold on a sec. Hey, sorry about that. No. Chapter 4, Club Titty Boo. Yeah, I didn't want to talk there because I didn't want to spoil that awesome cutscene. But, oh, what's this, a train? And lightning? This is weird. 3 years later, Tazmilly Village. Well, things have really changed. Do do boo do boo do 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 do. Oh, wrong song. Jeez, Tazmilly Village has really changed. It seems that facade is still around being an asshole. Yeah, this song right here is in Earthbound. It's what plays whenever you, like, sleep somewhere. And, like, it transitions from night to day. Or, you know what I mean. So, now we get control of Lucas, and apparently he has grown up a little bit since last time. So, let's come and look at the mirror. Aww. How sweet. Looking handsome. Yeah. So, yeah, if you do that, Lucas changes clothes. And I think you actually have to do that. So, this part is mostly just going to be like exploring the new Tazmilly Village. Because they said that things have changed, and you can apparently see that. Woof, woof. I could take you for a walk if you'd like, Lucas. What? Bony taking Lucas for a walk? Yeah, of course it has to go that way. Ooh, what's happened here? This doesn't look that good. Let's talk to these sheep. Bah! I got charred black. Okay. Bah! Lightning is scary. Yeah, I'm sure it is. Bah! Well, wild animals are afraid of lightning, but livestock are actually pretty okay with it. Okay, really? I did not know that. Say, frog? Hey, you there, boy! I realize this might be a bit of a bother, but please come talk to me. I have very important information for you. He just like moonwalk or moonhop backwards. From this day forth, you'll be rewarded for your hard work. It'll be given in units called DP, or Dragon Power. You can use DP in shops and other places in exchange for goods and services. Seems so far you've already earned 30 DP, or I totally chopped up that sentence. You can save and withdraw DP anytime by talking to nearby frogs. Some frogs in special locations can't conduct DP transactions, though. Ugh. Shall I explain all that again? No. Alright, then let's try it out. Time certainly flies, doesn't it? Do you need something? Yeah. Or perhaps chance for DP stuff. Now you'll see that with frogs, and basically, you go to DP stuff and you can withdraw your DP. But I'm not gonna take out any right now. You're holding out on saving, but I hope you're not holding out on using the bathroom too. Yeah. Because that wouldn't be very good. But basically, DP is the currency of this game, and it doesn't appear until Chapter 4. So that kind of sucks. But they give a very good explanation as to why that happens. Basically, it's because Tazmilly Village apparently adopted a money system, and before it was just a system of, like, bartering. But, yeah. And enemies will give you a certain amount of DP, but you won't automatically get it after you beat them. It'll be deposited to the save frogs. So, along with saying all the other enemy stats that I've said so far, with every single other enemy, I'm gonna have to... excuse me. I'm gonna have to add in there, DP. So... And some enemies will give a lot of DP, and some will give very little. So this is Tazmilly's famous lightning house. It really is incredible. It was definitely worth coming all the way here to see. Okay, really? You must really love being unhappy if you still refuse to get a happy box after all this. Facade's still trying to get people to buy those, or get those. The simple atmosphere, the smell of livestock and sea breezes. This is the only part of Tazmilly that hasn't changed a bit in the past 3 years. Well, that's good. Change is sometimes a bad thing. So up here, there is not a present like I thought there was. What have we got over here? Nothing? Okay, well, let's head into main Tazmilly Square. So, let's go ahead and just start looking about the town. Thomas's Shop, offering fascinating big city items faster and in greater quantities than anyone else. Things are different now, don't forget to bring DP. Now, let's check this out. Did you think so much beauty would blossom up in only 3 years? Huh? What? Am I talking about myself? No, of course not. I'm talking about Tazmilly. So, this is Thomas's shop. My dad is working over at the factory, so he left me in charge of the store. Would you like to buy something? Yeah, so this is when you finally get to buy stuff. And just like you would if you were going to equip something, if you're going to buy something, look up in the upper left and see if it will either up your stats or down your stats. And the kid shirt right here will up our stats. So I am going to buy one of those once I get enough. And basically, I'm going to need to save up 360 DP so I can buy a kid's shirt for Lucas, a kid's hat for Lucas, a kid's hat for Boney, and a Pisces bracelet for Lucas, because those will be extremely useful later. There's also sprinting bombs you can buy, and an alarm cicada that'll wake you up. So, that's the new shop and the new buying system. Everything else besides that is still the same. Nothing for turning iron red hot. This is the very latest automated model. Okay, yeah. Things have really changed. The Yaddo Inn had so much more warmth and friendliness up until 3 years ago. Oh, man, I hate winter. So anyway. Yeah, this place is a... grown pretty big. The DCMC band has a bassist named Lucky. He seems a little bum-like, but apparently he's a really good performer. Oh, really? Oh, pig masks. You're the type that just has to talk to everyone, aren't you? No, no, I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I think that's actually a very important thing to do. Oh, really? I hear they used to raise cows and pigs where the training facility to the southeast is now. Mr. Facade bought up all the land there. Hmm. The Happy Box is giving off some sort of light. Huh. Trivia card 1. Yeah. This is an item that you can use. Basically it has a question on it. And the enemy will give an answer as to what question it is. And if it's the right answer, nothing really exactly. I've never used these, but I think that if you... There's like 3 or 4, maybe even 5 of them throughout the game. And I believe if you use them all and get all the correct answers for them, you get some extra thing. I don't know when or what that is, but I'll have to look into that. Because I've never actually done that. But I will try it in the Let's Play. They say this village had no happy boxes until 3 years ago. Oh, really? Our Yado Inn has changed so much and gained so many new customers ever since Mr. Facade came to town. Let's check out what's up here. This hotel's poster girl is so cute. I wonder what her name is. I'm sure you do. Oh, quit running around, people. Why did you come in here? What was your reason? One, because I was enamoring. I don't know what that means. So you could flirt with me because you like me. Other. Which is it? All of the above. What's this guy? I'm in a luxury hotel, but surprisingly enough, I'm not acting nervous. Have you noticed? It's because my back pocket's filled with money I earned at the factory. Really?
Whisper. What do you want for lunch?
Whisper. Just anything but that pasta.
Whisper.
Croquette rolls are fine with me. No, actually, that's what I'd prefer.
Whisper.
But should we keep going until we find a good place to stop? A what? Okay. I'm about to go on a walk with my grandkid to Cerulean Beach. It'll be like old man on the beach and all that. Ho ho ho. Okay. Sniffle. Grandpa and I are supposed to go to the beach after I change into my swimsuit, but I can't take my eyes off this happy box. Sniffle. Wow, it's just a box that makes light. It's called a TV. They're not that amazing. Really. They're not. Okay. And then over here, we got another pig mask. Lightning struck Reggie's tent. But that's what he gets for not having a happy box. Jeez. Notice, our humble little shop, Caroline's Bakery, has also adapted the wonderful new DP system. Oh, this was the lady who would make you nut bread. Oh, and look, it's Fuel. And he's obviously grown up too. I love helping people out. That's good. That's a good quality to have. Potato-like men are my type. What? Really? Oh, Lucas, welcome. Fuel's been helping me out around the store lately. He's a real lifesaver. Oh, are you going to buy something? What can I get you? Well, let's see what she has. Nut cookie, nut bread, nut roll, or bread roll, peculiar cheese, fresh milk, fresh egg. Okay, I'm not gonna buy anything there. Now let's see what's to the east of the city. We got a save frog riding a little car. It's polished and sparkling. Really? Is there anyone who... Here, who puts money in this thing? Because I just did anyway. Okay. I have no idea what that does. I don't think that's even important. But if you look at it, it just says, if you have any extra money, please deposit it into here. I guess it's for these rich bastards that live here. You can see them earlier in the game if you want to. Oh, and look, it's Mapson. If you need something from the map-loving and map-owning Mapson, it must be a map, yes? I could talk about non-map stuff too, you know? Old Man West is definitely going to go bald. Yes, there's no doubt about it. Bald. Definitely. Okay. That's the best you can talk about? Oh, garbage can, but we can't rummage through it like in Earthbound. How sad. Oh, it's Abby. Eagle, our happy cooling box is just handy dandy. So I'm thinking of buying a happy massage chair next. Don't you think it's about time you at least put a happy box in your home already? No. Because apparently they're brainwashing everyone. Oh, Lucas. Are you so jealous of my happiness that you've come to see it for yourself? No. I'm just walking around. Exploring. Linda's over at the retirement home again, taking care of the senior citizens there. I wish she'd take care of me, too. Yeah. And this house is pretty spiffy. Widescreen flat panel thing. Is it a type of happy box? So basically, are they calling TVs happy boxes? And is that a Wii down there? I think it kind of looks like a Wii. Huh. Maybe it is. This game was made in 2006. So I guess they could fit a Wii in there. What do you got to say, buddy? Come on. Let's see. Crossroads Station is to the north, Cerulean Beach is to the west, and east of here is the nursing home for senior citizens. Oh, and to the south is your house, where lightning keeps striking. Alright, I finally figured out this town's layout. Okay, good for you. Well, okay, I guess we could check out what's going on here. Whenever I listen to Mr. Facade talk, I suddenly want everything. It's almost like he's a magician. Giggle. Yeah, he's just a silver-tongued bastard. Oh, Lucas, hi! Oh, hello there, Lucas. You look a bit down in the dumps. A happy box could really change your life, you know? Oh, hey there, Lucas. I hear your dad's still hiking up in the mountains looking for Klaus. You should really tell him yourself that it's about time he gave up already. Well, that's a little bad. He's ignoring you. Well, fine. Fine, I'll just go visit the old people, because old people always want attention. Anything down here? Oh, look at these guys. Stroke! 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 I'm Paddle, president of the Tazmilly Boat Club. Aside from the fact we don't have a boat, everything is going great. Stroke! 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 Yeah. Stroke! 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 I'm Ro, the newest member of the Tazmilly Boat Club. Aside from the fact we don't have a boat, everything is going great. Stroke! 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 Okay. Just repeat the same thing that the other guys said, why don't you? Bow wow! I keep getting hit by lightning. Did someone find out I peed on that happy box or something? Yeah. And here, I don't know if I showed this house, but there was some old guy who lived here. Time really flies. It's almost been half a year since old Scamp passed away. I get the feeling it's rare for scamps like him to be so easily forgotten. So in that sense, he's a great scamp. What's in here? Squawk, squawk. I'm not stuffed. I'm alive. I'm perfectly alive, dag nagger, or whatever you're going to say. Okay. Let's see what's down here. Doo-doo, boo-boo. Ew. This is our training facility. What do you think? Pretty impressive, huh? Burp, burp. I ain't signing off. I've just collapsed from sunstroke. Belch, burp. What are you, Nintendo Capri Sun? In a pig mask costume? Walking around? He seems to be captivated by the happy box. Yeah. Doop, doop, doop. What's going on here? Oh, you guys want to join our army too? Then you gotta eat lots and lots until you're nice and big first. Really? The marching song seems to be coming from the cassette player. Really? What's your guys' problems? You look like you're trying to screw up our formation or something. Really? You guys are just like marching around. You could actually interrupt their thing, like get in between them. But nothing really happens. And I believe they say some pretty funny things if you talk to them, but I'm not going to. Dang it, I promised that I wouldn't do any more 20-minute videos, but oh well. What's in here? I haven't seen Flint at all lately. How is he? Having your grandchildren visit is a true cause for happiness. Oh, hello, Lucas. Oh, and Bonnie, too. Your grandfather is upstairs in the room on the far left. I'm here visiting my grandma. We sometimes play games like Pin the Tail on the Leak, Hide and Go Sweep, and the Hokey Pokey. Yeah, I'm sure you do. Yeah. You do actually come here later. Oh, but I should go ahead and show this real quick. If you come back here, you can find Thunderbombs! But at this point, Most of the enemies are going to be strong enough to where thunder bombs are not going to be very strong against them. But you can still do the infinite bomb trick there, although really it's not that impressive anymore. To the west is the beach. That actually comes... Yeah, that's actually important later on, so I'll probably show that later, because I kind of want to move on. Maybe I'll just go to like 25 minutes or something. Or actually, you know what? I'm going to go and end this here, because I basically showed all the important parts of Tazmilly Village. I'm going to go and end this here and make this separate from the actual story part. So, if you've actually watched this entire video of me just walking around New Tazmilly, then thank you. But you really didn't have to, because there was no story involved except for beginning of the chapter and then explaining the TP system. Anyway, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end this part here. Next time in Let's Play Mother 3, we will move on with Chapter 4. So see you guys next time. Bye.